Yo, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another video here today on OP Legends. And today we're going to be trying to do some dungeons and try to improve our netherwort farm a little bit and expand it and make it a lot better. So in order to go ahead and do some dungeons, we are going to need some gear. If we take a look in the slash armor, we can see the current gear we can get is the iron gear. We do need level 24, the golden gear, and iron gear is easier to get. So in order to craft it, we just need one enchanted iron ingot for each piece of the set, and then we're probably gonna get a iron sword because I think we don't need both the axe and sword, so we're just gonna get the sword. It has a good attack speed and decent attack damage. So yeah, and in order to do that, we're gonna need about 4 stacks of iron that we're gonna get at spawn. So if you take a look in slash spawn, all we have to do is go to the right over here, and there is going to be a mine. So let me fly to it real quick. Okay, boom, here is the iron, and so we're just gonna mine a stack of it. This is our current pickaxe. We have a stone pickaxe with efficiency 3, so it can be a little bit better. And as we do keep trying to get better stuff, like probably better ores in there, like gold and stuff like that, we do only have a stone one right now. So let's go get the iron for the 4 pieces of iron gear that we do need. It might take me a little bit because, as you can see, if I mine iron, it's not too fast or too slow. It's just gonna take a little bit for 4 stacks of iron. And we did also get a spawner stack slot while I was just playing around. And basically what this does is it allows you to place another stack of spawners, and basically just will make us have a gooder farm once we do get a lot of spawners. The current way to get a lot of money and mob coins and XP and all that good stuff is netherwort still, and that's why I do want to go ahead and expand the farm later in the video. But for now, I do want to go ahead and do the dungeons because we haven't done the dungeons, and I'm pretty sure they are one of the coolest features on this server. So I do want to go ahead and showcase some of that and just do them for some spawn. I'm pretty sure you get spawners from them. You get a lot of loot and stuff. We have some dungeon cores, but I don't think I'm going to use them in my first run because I just want to experience it. And after, once I get better gear and stuff, I will use the dungeon cores. And dungeon cores are basically things you can use to boost your reward, XP, speed, just aspects of the dungeon. Like I have one here. It's an unusual dungeon core serpent 5. It basically has a 15% bonus reward chance, but it increases the enemy speed by 93%, so it has some boost and some drawbacks, but it is gonna help you. We also have 32,000 mob coins, which is kind of insane, and with those we can go ahead and buy an island upgrade pretty soon. Pretty sure we're gonna go for a, let me check real quick, crop growth speed, because this is gonna allow us to make our netherwort farm even faster. And I think I might go ahead and do it right now. Let me just check the other one's mob spawn. We don't have any spawners. We just can mine in the mine right here. We don't really need to upgrade our cobblestone generator. Yeah, let's go ahead and upgrade it once. Let's see, do we have another? And boom, so now we're at level 2 for the crop growth speed, so we're definitely gonna take that. It's gonna help our netherwort farm a lot. While I was mining, I did level up to mining level 7, so we did get 12 ultra pet boxes, which is gonna help us. I'm currently using a rare plus mob coins pet because we really want mob coins for those island upgrades. I want to go ahead and check my other skills out. So looks like our wood cutting is level 7, mining level 7, fishing level 2, and our farming is still only level 0, so we're gonna get 5 mil at level one. Let me get some points boosters, loot crates, pet boxes, all these good rewards, and they do get better as you keep leveling up. Let's see the last one. The last one gives you a monthly crate, which is kind of insane. So yeah, you do get some rewards for leveling up your skill, so the grind is definitely worth it. Right now our next reward is relic crates and then some chunk chest. We're definitely going to take the chunk chest and the spawner slot voucher once we do get to level 10, and honestly a cell one will be amazing for some spawners once we do get a farm set up for those. I finished mining and it looks like we have enough, so let's go ahead and go to the condensed table. And we have 4 stacks here, so let's condense it all. You have nothing to condense. Oh, forgot, we do have to smelt all the iron, which might take a little bit. So let me go to my island and smelt it all, and I'll come back once I've done it. And then from that, we'll condense it into the iron enchanted ingot. Okay, so I've got all the iron, so now let's condense it all. Boom, condense. And then one more time, boom. So now we have the 4 iron ingots. Let's go into the armor and buy all the gear that we do need. So boom, chest plate, leggings, and then the boots. And then let's go at the sword, why not? And then boom, boom, boom. Okay, now we have the dungeon armor we're gonna be using for this dungeon. I don't know if we need like golden apples or anything like that, but I might get one just in case if I even can. But yeah, now I'm gonna go empty my inventory and get the dungeon started. I don't really know if I can get a golden apple. We go to spawn, I think the dungeons are back over there. We're also gonna start the dungeon quest, which is gonna be good because it will give us some stuff that we do need. So boom, let's go ahead and click him. Okay, so we do need level 20, it looks like. I thought there was a starter one. Since the requirement is level 20, I probably grind a bit. It won't take too long to actually get level 20 with our netherwort farm. And oh my gosh, guys, I just realized I made a mistake. If we do slash quest, you can actually see that the first quest that you talk to the dungeon master at spawn will actually give you 5 enchanted iron ingots to actually craft the iron gear. So we did not have to do all that mining, but honestly, we can use those for like some tools, like a pickaxe, shovel, and all of those. And so since the quest is to talk to him, boom, we got the 5 enchanted iron ingots. And now we have to craft 4 pieces of iron dungeon gear using slash armor. I guess our previous armor didn't count, so I guess we just have to spend it on more pieces of armor. And I'm gonna go ahead and get an axe too, because why not? So we're gonna see the dungeon iron. Boom, let's go get the iron axe. And let's just get the armor again, I guess. And boom, now we have crafted all of the armor that we do need. So now we just need to talk back with the dungeon master. And there is no dummies dwell that is telling me to do. And just spawn me in it, actually. So boom, we're just gonna do it real quick. You just walk up to this door and break it, I'm pretty sure. And I'm pretty sure you could get some good rewards from the dungeons, like spawners and stuff like that, crate keys, all that good stuff. Okay, so this is the start of it. There is some basic mobs here that we just have to go ahead and kill. They're not too hard. This is basically just the starter, like beginner tutorial dungeon. If we go up here, there should be a hidden chest with some loot up here, I'm pretty sure. Right here, boom, right click it. Looks like there's some experience. So now let's go into the next room and kill these. There is some hidden chest that you guys do want to be on the lookout for. That's how you will get some extra loot from these dungeons. Okay, there's a next chest right here. Boom, looks like we got some pet boxes, one pet box from it. Not the best, but this is the basic tutorial dungeon kind of thing, so the rewards aren't going to be too good. And there is a secret chest up here that we want to go ahead and get. Okay, so from this chest we got some more experience. Let's go on to the next room. Boom, let's kill this guy real quick. I don't think there's a hidden chest in this one. Yeah, it doesn't look like it. So let's go into the next one, and there is a like final room somewhere, I'm pretty sure. Okay, so this is the final room. This is, they're gonna be like a boss, I think, I don't know. But let's just kill all of these prototype, these little guys. They only have one health, so they're like one shot to anything. And it says, yes, layer, you're currently on layer one. It says we have to kill all the mobs in order for the shield to assemble. So let's just go ahead and kill all of them real quick. They are really easy to kill. All these mobs either have one heart or two hearts, so they're like one shot. And then these ones are a little bit harder to kill, but there's still nothing crazy. You should be able to kill them pretty easily. And then a lot of mobs will spawn, and you have to go back to the totem right here. So I'm pretty sure we just have to climb up it, and then boom. Now we just stay up here. I'm pretty sure they all should die. Let's just go ahead and kill this one. This is unfair time to up the ante. I mean, these mobs can't really come up here, so I'm pretty sure this is where you have to go. There is ladders, and then fast click the glass below. Boom, and then they all should die, and then boom. That is the end of the dungeon, I'm pretty sure. And as you can see, it is really, really easy for the starter dungeon. Now once you complete it, you will get points. It looks like it says I'll give you some points. And so that is the first dungeon that you're going to be doing, and it is really, really easy. From that, we got a tier one quest box. Let's go ahead and open up that. Boom, hopefully we can get something good from it. It looks like we're level 18, so should get some better rewards than once we first started at level 0. Looks like some XP, mob coins, and some money. Not anything too crazy, but we're definitely going to take it. I think the points that we did get from the dungeon were the ones for the levels on the top of the screen, because we are level 18 now. So the dungeons are a good way to get some points and some spawners and some extra loot, and they're honestly really fun to do. And the first one is really, really easy if you just are starting out. Now I want to go ahead and go back to the island, and I want to go ahead and showcase the farm a little bit and maybe expand it and make it better. Okay, so we completed the dungeon, and I'm just gonna keep this armor on for now, but we have our hoe. Let me go ahead and actually get our pet. We are currently using the rare mob coins pet, because we do need mob coins to if we go into IS upgrades, we need it for the crop growth speed, and we can actually buy another level of it. So we will be at a level 3 out of 5, which is honestly really good, because we only need 2 more levels to fully max out the crop growth speed. So yeah, we're definitely gonna take that. And on our hoe, we currently have replant and telepath, just so we can automatically replant and automatically get the crops into our inventory. We honestly get so many crops. Like, if we just mine like this, you can see we get so many. Like, we already have like 5 stacks, and they sell for like about 1,200 per nether ore, which is kind of insane. If we get a full inventory, I think it's around 2.5 mil without a money pet, and we do actually have a money pet that we did recently get. So we're gonna go ahead and start using those from now on. But we are almost at a full inventory just for grinding for a few seconds, which is kind of insane. And we are level 19 now. So yeah, this is honestly the best way to start making money and leveling up, as long as getting some mob coins. So I do really, really recommend getting a nether ore farm with a decent hoe, basically iron with replant and telepath, just so you don't have to keep replanting and stuff. Let's go ahead and sell it all, and that sold for 2.2 mil. We didn't quite have a full inventory, but it was quite close. So yeah, 2.2 mil without a money pet or any boosters is kind of insane for just starting off. We have 20 mil right now. We could go ahead and buy some spawners if we really wanted to, but I think we're gonna go ahead and save a little bit just so we get a decent spawner. So like, zombies cost 4 mil and drop rotten flesh. If we go into the crops, rotten flesh sell for 270 money each, which actually isn't that bad if we're gonna be AFKing. So we might go ahead and invest and make a mob grinder in a future video, but I think for now we're just gonna keep grinding our nether ore. We're almost at level 20, and once we do get to level 20, we're gonna be able to unlock a lot of armor and gear. If we go ahead and go to the gear, that means we'll be able to unlock gold, and the dungeons will be able to unlock gold gear there too. And there's also grinding armor, which I actually honestly haven't really looked at this, which is non-PVE purposes like farming and grinding, and this is gonna help a lot. So it requires level 20. So once we do get level 20, let's go ahead and do that real quick. We're going to be able to unlock so many good things that are going to help us make even more money and grind even more better. So we've got level 20. We did get a milestone. We got a money booster, 3 loot crates, and an ultra pet box. We'll open up those later. Let me sell this nether wart. But now let's go ahead and take a look at the armor. I do want to go ahead and look at the recipe for the gold. It looks like we're going to need 24 enchanted spruce wood, 2 enchanted golden ingots, 50k money. So we can definitely get the money and gold in ingots pretty easily. But the 24 enchanted spruce wood might take some time. So I'm probably going to craft a iron axe to help speed that up and maybe enchant it with some efficiency. And if we take a look at the grinding armor, the scarecrow armor. So we need 48 hay bales, 12 enchanted spruce wood, and 75k. And basically what this does is increases the farming fortune and gives us a multiplier and boost and speed. So these are going to help us a lot. We're probably going to try to get all of these maybe off camera, and I'm going to showcase it in the next video. I don't really know, but yeah, these are going to help us a ton. But that's going to be it in today's video. In the next video, I want to get a lot of good gear like the golden and scarecrow set. But yeah, that's going to be it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.